What's up internet, welcome to the second tutorial in PL SQL Ref Cursor series. Today's video will be about strong ref cursor in Oracle database. As we learned in the previous tutorial, the ref cursor which returns some value is called a strong ref cursor, or we can say that a ref cursor which has fixed return type is called a strong ref cursor. So without wasting much of your time, let's move ahead and see what does it mean. In order to keep the concept of creating a strong ref cursor simple and easy to understand, we will do a very basic example. Let's do that. After setting the server output on, we started the declaration section of our PL SQL block. Here, we declared our ref cursor type with the name my_refcur. The return clause in the end of the statement makes it a strong ref cursor. One thing which you have to take care while creating a strong ref cursor in Oracle PL SQL is that the return value of a strong ref cursor must always be a record type. It can either be a table-based record or a user-defined record. In our case, the return value of my_refcur is a table-based record where we used employees table of HR schema. If you want to learn more about table-based record data type, then you can refer to the PL SQL tutorial 33. After declaring the ref cursor, next we have to create a cursor variable which will be used to refer to our cursor type. Let's create that variable. You just have to write the name of your cursor variable followed by the name of your ref cursor. The former could be anything. After all, it's completely user defined. As here in our case, we created a cursor variable with the name cur_var. Next, we will create another variable for holding the data which we will be fetching from our ref cursor. Let's create that as well. Here we have another table-based record data type variable for holding the data from our ref cursor. Next, we will write the execution section in which we will put this strong ref cursor to work. Let's do it. Here we have our execution section. In this section, we have four executable statements. Let's see what these are. The first statement is an open for statement. It associates the select statement with the cursor variable and opens the cursor for the statement. This statement also looks for all the resources required for processing the select statement. In our case, this open for statement is opening our ref cursor for the select statement in which we are selecting data from all the columns of employees table of HR schema for employees whose employee ID is 100. Second statement is a fetch statement. As we discussed in PL SQL tutorial 26, the process of retrieving the data from the cursor is called fetching. Using this fetch statement, we are fetching the data from our strong ref cursor into the variable rec_var. Once we are done with our cursor, then it is advisable to close it so that our Oracle engine /server can relinquish all the resources associated with it. That's exactly what we have done in the third statement. In this statement, using close keyword followed by the cursor variable, we have closed our ref cursor. And then there comes the last statement, which is the output statement. In this statement, we are displaying back the first name and the salary of the employee. You can refer to the PL SQL tutorial 33 to learn the working of a table-based record variable. There I have explained how to initialize a record variable and access the data from it using dot notation. Anyways, these four statements wrap up our execution section of this program. Before finding out what will be the output of this tutorial, I will take a quick second to ask you to like this video. Your love and support always keeps me motivated for doing my work and producing more such videos. Also, if you are new here on my channel, then my dear friend, go ahead and subscribe, as many more such interesting tutorials are yet to come. That being said, let's get back to our tutorial and execute our program to see the result. On successful execution, the output should be the first name and salary with the formatted string of the employee whose ID is 100. Let's execute and see. But before that, we have to make sure that we are connected to the HR schema because we are working with the employees table which is stored onto it. Now let's execute. Here is our result, which is the first name and the salary of the employee. As we saw that this tutorial requires a working knowledge of cursor lifecycle and record data type. If you are not aware of these two topics, then I suggest you to watch my tutorial on PL SQL cursors as well as record data types. Link is in the description as always. So that is the tutorial on how to create a strong ref cursor. This example demonstrated the case where we retrieved everything from the table in our cursor. What if we want the data from some specific column of the table? Will this example still be suitable for that? In order to find out the answer, stay tuned, as in the next tutorial, we will learn how to create a strong ref cursor with user-defined record variable. Do make sure to share this video with your friends on your social media. That way you can help others in learning as well as help me and my channel in growing. This is the tutorial on how to create strong ref cursors in Oracle PL SQL. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.